أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله أولئك هم الصادقون بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يرى ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يرى صدق الله العظيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي My respected brothers and my sisters, last days of Ramadan, there is a message for you and me from Quran. You know, I was reading one book written about Tajweed rules, and preface of that book was written by Maulana Abul Hasan Ali Nadvi rahmatullah alayh. Maulana writes that you know, approach of today's Muslim towards Quran is different than the approach of Sahaba. Sahaba's approach was not to have command on Quran or learn as much as Quran possible. Rather, they were practical people. Their approach was action oriented. They were focused on the spirit and ruh of the message of Quran and the teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's good to know and learn and excel how to do tajweed of Quran, how to read Quran, to have knowledge of Quran. But wallahi, most of the time I have seen we get lost and we lose the real focus, the real spirit, the real purpose of Quran. Quran is a book of action. Quran is a book of commitment. Quran is a book of response. Whatever little knowledge I accumulate, I have to commit. I have to act on it. My brothers, this was the major difference. Sahaba were not people who were trying to pile up all the information and knowledge, you know, lectures and knowledge and durus. Rather, whatever little knowledge they had action plan according to that information and knowledge. In the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one man came from outside Medina, and when he reached to Masjid Nabawi, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw him and suggested that you should go and live with Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu and learn Islam from Ali. The man left with Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. After some time, Prophet ﷺ saw Hazrat Ali and asked and inquired about that man, how is he doing? Hazrat Ali said, Ya Rasulullah, he stayed with me only for a few days and then he left. And I don't know his whereabouts, where he is. Prophet ﷺ asked Sahaba that if you find that man in Medina, ask him to visit me. After 2-3 days, Sahaba spotted him at marketplace and asked him that Prophet ﷺ wanted to see you. He came to Prophet ﷺ. Prophet inquired to this man that I asked you to stay with Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu and learn deen. Look at the response of this sahabi. He says, Ya Rasulullah ﷺ, I learned, you know, my deen. Prophet ﷺ said, what do you mean you learned your deen? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I learned 2 ayahs of Quran. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى The meaning of these ayah is that if I will do any deed as little as like a particle or atom, I will be rewarded on that day. And if I will do any bad deed, even as little as of particle size or atom size, I will be punished. Ya Rasulullah, before I do anything, this is my gauge, this is my scale, this is my yardstick on which I judge my actions before I do. Prophet ﷺ said, you got it. He understood the core message of Islam. My brothers and my sisters, same way, if you remember that hadith in which one man came to Prophet ﷺ and said, Ya Rasulullah, tell me what is mandatory, obligatory, minimum for me. Prophet ﷺ said, 5 times fard prayer, fasting of month of Ramadan, and if you have means, then you have to give zakat, and if you have means, then you have to go one time for Hajj. He says, Ya Rasulullah, I will not do more or less than what you have just told me. and left. Prophet said, if he was truthful on what he was saying, then he succeeded. My brothers and my sisters, wallahi, our deen is a deen of action, deen of commitment, deen of conviction. Focused. I remember one story when Central Asia, Soviet Union was one country, there was no permission to have Quran in your home. In this whole village, there was only one Quran. This Muslim brother, after he passed away, people were taking his janazah towards the cemetery, graveyard, Qabristan. And people noticed a strange thing, that white pigeons were flying on sky to provide shade to his body, to his janazah, up until they buried. While they were burying him, they were circling on his grave. Very strange thing people noticed. After they buried him, they went to his home and asked his wife, what were his deeds? What unique thing he was doing that we have not seen this before? What we saw? She said, you know, in our town, as you know, there is only one Quran. Every family gets once a month chance to have copy of Quran at night time. This man's routine was, when our turn comes, he will stay all night up. He did not know how to read Quran. He did not know much of deen. He did not know any Arabic. But he will stay all night up, and he will sit in front of Quran, and he will put his finger on every line, every page of Quran, and will witness out loud, these are words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is a haq, and I have full faith on every letter of this book. My brothers and my sisters, whatever little he knew, he had committed. He had full conviction. He had unshakable iman on that. The second message I want to give to myself and everybody, you know, this Quran is not a dead book. It's a live book. When we read Quran, it's talking to you and me. Like Allama Iqbal's father used to tell Allama Iqbal, when you read Quran, think that it's getting revealed on your heart right now. So Quran is talking to you, expecting your response. My brother, that's what the habit of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was. When he used to read Quran in his Nafil Salah, Nafil prayers, if Jannah is mentioned, then he will stop, he will pause, and he will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant him Jannah. If there is a mention of Jahannam, he will pause and stop, and he will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protection from the hellfire. My brothers and my sisters, this book is a book of response, needs commitment, needs conviction, needs unshakable iman. So if you and me, we do not know how to respond to Quran while we are reading because we don't know Arabic that much, I will suggest one thing. Try to get in habit of reading Quran at Fajr time. Before Fajr or after Fajr. This was a Muslim home culture. The first voice kids will hear, family members will hear from the Muslim house in the morning was Quran. Let's get back to our traditions. When you read Quran, Fajr time, أقم الصلاة لدلوك الشمس إلى غسق الليل وقرآن الفجر إن قرآن الفجر كان مشهودا. The Quran we read in the morning, Fajr time, will become witness for you and me on the day of judgment. My brothers and my sisters, so I will request, in reading of Quran at Fajr time, try to develop, you know, relationship with Quran. Try to develop this love and longing for Quran, passion for Quran. And we need to respond what we read. So if you read one ruku, read translation of it and ponder and contemplate on that ruku. If you say Alhamdulillah, let your whole body feel thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on all the bounties He has given. If you read about Jannah, then raise your hand And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Jannah. Yet if you read about Jahannam, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protection. This will be my tadabbur, my contemplation with Quran. My brothers and my sisters, this will be my response to the message of Quran. Wallahi, if you and me, we interact with Quran this way, our heart, our iman, our spiritual being, we will be at a different station. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you and me this tawfiq that we can continue our relationship with Quran after Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you and me tawfiq that we can have more bonding with Quran. We can have more longing for Quran, more passion for Quran and love of Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah.